The International Monetary Fund, the IMF, has revised downward its 2028 gross domestic forecast for Nigeria to 2% from the initial 2.5% it had predicted earlier. This is as one of the leading global ratings agencies, Moody's, noted that government debt burdens in Nigeria and other economic community of West African states have risen significantly. Joining me to discuss global market matters, brewery sector in Nigeria, and questionable investments is Babajide Atolagbe, research analyst from Afrinvest. Babajide, you are very welcome. Thanks for joining us on the Global Business Report. Now, we're going to start with global matters, yes? First of all, the IMF, with regards to what's been going on as far as the downgrade and the general macroeconomic environment. Tell us, what's been happening?
So recently, we saw the IMF downgrade Nigeria's GDP forecast from 2.5% to 2% for 2020. So basically, this reflects the deteriorating macroeconomic environment, the prospect for a deteriorating macroeconomic environment. So we could see that, looking at it from the fiscal angle, you could see that the government actually lacks some capability to fund the 2020 budget. Mm. And this is largely on the back of the decline in oil prices that we've seen in recent time, which is largely due to the coronavirus outbreak in China.
Yes.
So basically, all of these factors are things that the IMF has majorly looked at and seen that Nigeria is quite not still sustainable yet to carry out its fiscal obligations and also do what it needs to do. Also, you also look at some policies in Nigeria are not favorable. Also, the fact that we've seen rising inflation. Inflation report came in today at 12.1%. Simply shows you the deteriorating how unfriendly it is to do business in Nigeria. Mm. So all of these factors are what the IMF have actually put together and came up with the downgrade in forecast.
All right, now let's get our next slide up here. I want to look at the brewery sector, and in particular, Nigerian breweries, one of the major players, which I believe they released their 2019 full year results.
Yeah,
yes. What are we seeing with regards to Nigerian breweries and how they performed?
So actually, we saw a decline in revenue for Nigerian breweries of about 0.4% to settle at 3 to 3 billion naira in 2019.
Okay.
And this could be largely attributed to the increased competition in the brewery sector, or weaker consumer spending, which has actually characterized most of 2018 and 2019, and as well as the limited opportunities for price increase in that sector. So still on competition, we've seen the likes of International Brewery, Guinness and Champion all intensifying efforts to gain a favorable share of the market share.
Okay.
So given the fact that the Nigerian Brewery is a market leader in that space, this has negatively affected their top line.
Mm.
In terms of consumer spending, the macroeconomic environment, like I said earlier, has done little or nothing to encourage consumer spending. So, we've had series of issues from rising inflation,
mm-hmm.
high level of unemployment rate, and so many factors that are weighing on demand, which indirectly affects the consumer goods sector largely. So all of these factors put together is the major reason why we're seeing a decline in the revenue of about 0.4%.
Okay, excellent. So yeah, so this is what you just mentioned, right? Revenue dropped 0.4% to 323 billion. Also seeing their cost of sales also moderated a bit. Yeah, I think about 2.9%, yeah? What about, I think the next slide we have is their operational, I think operational costs, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, how's that, finance costs rather, OPEX and their net finance costs. What are we seeing here?
So in OPEX, we saw a slight increase of about 6.8% to 97 billion in 2019. And this is largely driven by the intensified competition, like I mentioned earlier.
Mm.
You know, Nigerian Brewery is the market leader and has been around for a while. So we attribute the increase in market cost to brand sustainability, you understand, in terms of marketing and advert cost. So basically,
uh-huh.
those are the major drivers of cost in that space.
Advertising is not cheap. Okay, what about their finance costs?
Yeah, so looking at the net finance cost, it's actually spiked by 57.4% to 11.9 billion.
Yeah, yeah.
So if we want to analyze this, we observe that based on the weak business environment,
yes.
the company did not really have or did not generate enough cash flow to finance its short-term obligation.
Mm.
So we attribute the rise in finance costs to the issuance of commercial paper in 2019 and as well as an increase in bank overdraft in 2019. So the proceeds from this overdraft were basically used to finance their short-term obligations.
Okay, what about, and I think we have another slide up still on their performance here. Now, as far as the so we've got the revenues down, operating costs down. Of course, this now trending down towards their profit after tax, PBT and PAT, yes?
Yeah, so it's also declined as well. It declined about 20.6% and 17.1% to 16.1 billion naira and 23.4 billion naira respectively. So this is just the quantitative representation of all you've seen from revenue downwards to
their final. Okay. Now, I understand, I think we've also got the corporate actions with regards to, here we go. Proposed dividends, dividend yields, and a number of other things. To take us through, take us through this.
So they actually proposed a dividend of 2 naira per share, and dividend yield equivalent to the price as at today is 3.9%. Okay. This is still, you may want to say it's a little bit small, looking at what you have in the fixed income environment, yields are currently low. A T-bill rate of about 92 days, you get something lower than this. So, this is still a little bit favorable, given the time horizon that you're going to be getting your dividend payment in April 2020. So this has just been the basic thing they've given to us so far.
And you don't have a recommendation on the stock as of yet, correct? Because it's still under review?
So at the moment, it's still under review, but shortly we'll have our recommendations out already.
But anyway, based on what you said, thank you for the analysis. The brewery sector, challenging year for everybody, all the players involved.
Yeah, it's actually a challenging year for everyone, all market players, because, starting from the first place, and like I said, they've been having issues in increasing prices because of the nature of their consumers. Mm. There's a high level of, price elasticity because of the oligopolistic nature of the industry. So a slight change in prices may actually affect your market share. So,
and just to help out our viewers, an oligopoly is where you just have a few players controlling a market, like two things. Cement, I think we see that is there as well. All right, I want to go to this next interesting slide, This is still on investing. Now, we had to cover up, just for our viewers, we didn't want to advertise who this is, but this is from a BRT bus, which was noticed somewhere in Lagos State. Someone reached out to us, at Arise, saying, hey, someone's, is this actually legitimate where you can invest 100,000 naira and get 50% return in 6 months? I bring this up because the SEC actually made an announcement that they had recovered some money from Wonder Banks and all these wild investment schemes out there that they're working towards trying to close them down so that Nigerians don't fall victim. 50% in 6 months in corn. Is this possible in this investment environment where you literally just talked about a 3.2% dividend yield from a publicly traded company and a 92-day T-bill or 91-day T-bill giving you even less than that? Yeah, exactly.
So honestly, taking a look at the return is actually very attractive. I know, Rutish, you can see to that 50% in 6 months, but at the end of the day, the major fact is what are the risks attached to this type of investment? Mm-hmm. And absolutely, in a corporate space, you won't find portfolio fund managers investing their money in this type of instrument, in this type of asset classes, basically because of the risk attached to it. So, in the long run, I would just say this may be a little bit over the brink for investors.
With all of these investments are put out there, they don't seem to tell Nigerians the risks that are involved.
They are never highlighted. As you can see, the slides, the biggest figure you can see in the slide is the 50%
return. Is the return.
And it's just in 6 months. So the major risks, the downside risks, are obviously not going to be stated. So people just, venture their money into stuff like this, and at the end of the day, it becomes
A sad story.
Ends in tears.
It ends in tears, as is the famous words that they say. Okay, we're running out of time now. As far as the outlook for the stock market, I think things are still a bit tepid with regards to foreign investments, foreign participation, and domestic participation in the stock market. Yeah.
Yeah. So far we've seen sell-offs in the stock market since over 2 weeks now, and this is just simply telling us about the deteriorating business climate in Nigeria. So investors are not really, there's a little or no optimism in the market. So you could remember at the beginning of the year, the market was up around 9.1% year to date. But as at now, I can tell you it's around 3.4% or 4% thereabouts. So it simply tells you that, investors are obviously, taking a risk side approach to the equities market.
Okay, so what needs to happen? Is it policy reform that the investors are waiting to see, or is there something bigger in order for appetite to be increased in the stock market as things are right now?
So it's going to be a mix of both global and domestic factors to boost investors' appetite towards our stock market. Basically, global in terms of oil prices, if we see a surge in oil prices very soon, it could spur investors towards Nigeria's equities market. And domestically, you know, I'll just say the our infrastructural deficit that has been the major risk or major downside that investors are actually quite wary of. So those are the major things that, you know, need to be put in place for you to, you know, to reawaken the investor sentiment.
Okay, so you just mentioned, we only have about a minute or two left, but you just mentioned the infrastructure deficit. There's so much money that needs to be pumped into our infrastructure in order for it to get to where it needs to be. Essentially, we have to borrow more money. And there's been talk, of course, of the size of our debts. Does that worry you guys from your perspective at Afrinvest when you look at Nigeria's, I think it's at 26 trillion now or so, 17 trillion being external, 8 being domestic or so, if I have the figures correct. Are you guys worried about the debt levels?
Yeah, it's actually worrisome because, trust me, if you're a country and your debt is that elevated, it should be a thing of worry for you. Also, debt servicing has been on the ice for the past 4 years.
Right.
Now, for debt service,
revenue
is about 60%.
Right. So
take, for example, now, for every $100 you earn now, you're giving 60% out as debt. So it shows you the unsustainability in Nigeria's fiscal space.
Babajide Atolagwe of Afrinvest, research analyst. Thank you so much for talking about the global matters, brewery sector, and questionable investments.